You started. We've already accomplished one goal, and we're only a few seconds into this run. And you may think I'm joking around right now. Well, I'm not. You started a run. That means at some point today, you decided you were going to set as a goal to run. And like I already said, you're running because you pressed start. One goal met. Now, let's extend the celebration by running this whole 40-minute run together. I'm Coach Bennett, the Nike Running Global Head Coach. And you know we're not alone. We've got the one and only Andy Puddicombe. Andy's the co-founder of Headspace, and he's with us for the whole run. And every stride we do with Andy gets us running towards our goals in a better and more mindful way. Andy, as always, thank you so much for running with us.
Hey, as always, Coach, my pleasure.
Well, right now, you should be running comfortably, relaxed, and with patience as you ease into the run. So let's make sure that's what we're doing right now. The effort should be relaxed, and it should be comfortable. And you need to release any tension you may have in your body and replace any anxiety you have about this run with patience. Be patient with yourself, and you'll find that calm you need when you start a run the right way.
Yeah, you know, Coach, I know you always emphasize this point from a physical point of view. You know, and rightly so, making sure the body has time to warm up. And the same is true for the mind, of course. We need to start slowly, patiently, making sure that we ease into the run. So now's not the time to be pushing with lots of effort. Now's the time to be letting go of all the thinking, to check in with your posture, to settle your attention on the stride. So make sure you're running comfortably, free from resistance. Make sure you're applying minimum effort. If you're thinking of something that happened today, let it play out in the mind and then just let it go. If you're thinking of something that's happening that might happen that could happen tomorrow or sometime in the future, let it play out and then let it go. So with each stride, we step out of the mind and into the body. With each strike of the foot, we become a little less heady and a little more grounded. So just slowly warming up in that way.
Just makes sense, doesn't it?
What's that?
Well, the right way to start a run or to begin a session of meditation. If you stop and think about what you're trying to do, really think about it, it all just makes perfect sense. You go from not running to running. And the typical reaction is to force and push and rush the process, when what you should be doing is running relaxed and easing into the effort and being patient. It just makes sense, but it doesn't matter that it makes sense because we more often than not push and force and rush it. And I know you see these same issues with meditation as I see with running.
Yeah, I'm so happy you brought that up, Coach. You know, your advice on this when it comes to running has been a revelation to me personally. You know, I used to go out really hard, and now I have really, really old grandparents with hip replacements passing me as I warm up. And, you know, and it feels good, and it makes for a much better run. You know, when I was a monk, my teacher used to say, if you're doing an hour of meditation, forget about the first 15 minutes or so. That's just settling in. If it was a 10-minute meditation, he'd say, you know, don't worry too much about the first couple of minutes. That's just getting comfortable and checking in. And the same is true for our run. The first part's not about results. It's not about getting it's more about getting the body and mind working together, just settling into the run. So as we run today, you know, it's natural for thoughts to come into the mind. As much as possible, simply acknowledge them and let them go as you bring your attention back into the body, back into the stride, and back into the foot strike. And it doesn't matter. This is really important. It doesn't matter whether they're happy running thoughts, sad running thoughts, excited running thoughts, anxious running thoughts. Thoughts about our mind, our emotions, our body, our training, our family, our friends, maybe our partners, our pets, our work, anything in life. They're just thoughts. So just letting them pass. And know that in starting this run, you're doing something positive. Something positive for you and for the people around you in your life. So the run's begun. You started the run. No one can take that away from you. You're training your body. You're training your mind. You're nurturing your body. You're nurturing your mind. And you're influencing your life and the life of others. So the world needs your positivity. It sounds kind of funny, but it's true. Don't underestimate the value of taking the time out to look after the mind, to look after the body, and to do something as simple as going for a run.
Oh, I like that. Actually, I love that. Because it's so important to hear, important for everyone to hear. We have reminders and alerts and alarms that we set all day long that tell us we need to do this or do that or get to this meeting or pick up something or drop off something. I like the idea of setting reminders for yourself to just celebrate what you've done or even celebrate what you plan on doing. And I think that's essential as we start to talk about setting, resetting, and reaching goals.
Sounds good to me, Coach. And, you know, we can start by celebrating the start of this run right now, right? So feel good about having made the decision. Feel good about following through on that decision. This is already a win, and we're only just getting into the run. Whatever the goals we set ourselves in life, whether they're big or small, it's important to acknowledge when we follow through, to celebrate that, to reinforce the behavior and to strengthen our resilience and our passion to rinse and repeat.
Okay, well, Andy, do your thing. Talk a little bit about how we can all set reminders internally or externally that keep our movement going forward and can serve as inspiration from ourselves and for ourselves as we run through our days. I imagine that those reminders can actually be powerful bits of motivation for us to keep working or running towards a specific goal or just towards a better version of ourselves.
Yeah, for sure. You know, it's a funny thing. People often think that mindfulness and goal setting are somehow opposed to each other because mindfulness is focused on being in the present and goal setting is focused in the future. But we can set goals, we can plan for the future, get clarity around our intention all whilst we're here in the present. In fact, that's the only place that we can do it. So the start point is being clear in your intention. Sounds easy, but often we don't reach our goals simply because we don't have clarity on what we want to achieve and how we're going to get there. It's just too vague. So get specific, be clear. And then reflect on what motivates you. What's going to keep you going? What's going to sustain you on your journey? And then break it down. Rather than focus on that long-term goal, focus on this week, this day, this run, or even this moment. If you truly give everything to each and every moment, then there's no more you can do in achieving that goal. It will simply unfold as it will. So this means you can truly celebrate each moment on the journey, knowing that it's part of the goal. In focusing less on the final destination and more on the process itself, we experience less anxiety, less fear, less pressure, less stress, and instead we feel energized, we feel motivated, everything and anything feels positive. So keep that in mind as you continue to run now. And Coach and I will be back here in a few minutes' time.
And we're already over 7 minutes in. We're over 10 minutes in, and that means we're back together again. You, the runner, me, and Andy Puddicombe of Headspace. Okay, Andy, you just had our great runner spend some time thinking about and working on ways they can be mindful of the work they're doing towards a goal or just towards a better version of themselves. I want to go back a bit in the process.
Sure thing, what are you thinking?
I want to actually talk about setting goals.
Great. Talk to me, coach.
Okay. Setting goals can be a really fun experience. You're thinking about the future. You're obviously thinking about accomplishing something, so that visualization you're naturally doing is positive. And setting a goal demands a certain level of self-belief or confidence.
Or both.
Or both. Why is it then that goal setting can be terrifying for some people? And for others, it doesn't lead to feeling confident, but rather feelings of unworthiness. The visualization can be negative for some people. I'll give you an example. I wanted to write 10 minutes every day this year.
Okay, so I know that you love to write, so I should imagine you've probably nailed that.
Well, let me finish. 10 minutes of writing, and it can't be about running.
Okay, yeah, all of your writing's about running.
Yeah, so it started off super exciting. I thought about a whole bunch of topics I'd love to write about. I thought about a body of work I'd have after 365 days of writing. I even thought to myself, hey, maybe this even becomes a book.
Nice. I'll look out for it.
Yeah, well, let me finish again. And then I thought about when I would do it. And do I really want to write a book? And do I really want to write about a whole bunch of random things? And I already write a lot about running anyway, so why would I want to write even more than I do? And maybe this is a stupid goal, and this all literally went down in my head in the span of 2 minutes.
Yeah, the mind can be, I think, like a washing machine sometimes, and I think that kind of thinking is pretty normal for what it's worth.
Well, thank you for telling me that. Now tell me, and everyone else, how I could have handled this differently. Because 10 minutes a day of writing for me may be training to run a fast 5K or 10K for someone else. It could be trying to run the Chicago Marathon for somebody. It could be doing 10 push-ups or 1 minute of plank every day or simply drinking a glass of water every morning before you grab that first cup of coffee. The goal could be a session of mindfulness and meditation every day. So talk to me about how I could have just handled this differently.
Yeah, you know, I don't want to repeat myself, but these things are really important. So I'm just going to come back to those few things that I mentioned earlier. I think we kind of almost can't hear these enough. Number one, be clear about your intention. So what's your goal and why do you want to achieve it? Is the intention healthy? Will it positively impact your life? Could it even influence the lives of those around you? Maybe even inspire people you don't even know? And by the way, coach, the answer is yes to all of those on your book. Next, be sure that you give yourself the best possible chance of meeting that intention. So obviously, take care of any practical things, but also look at what's going to inspire and motivate you along the way. Maybe it's a person. Maybe it's a memory. It might be a movie, a podcast. It might be a combination of them all. But whatever it is, be sure it's sustainable. So once the intention and motivation are taken care of, we can get down to one step at a time. Now, kind of sounds cliche, but every goal ever achieved happened one step at a time, one moment at a time, everything, ever. So some would say that each step is part of the process. I'd go a step further. Each step is the goal itself. So the step towards the goal and the goal itself, they're not different. They're one in the same thing. And that's what it means to focus less on the destination and more on the journey. And this is why we should celebrate every step along the way. You have doubts? Of course. It's human to feel doubt. You have anxiety or fear? Of course. It's human to feel those emotions. So we might think that because we experience those things that we're not up to the task. But noticing those things means we're aware. And awareness gives us a choice. Do we grab hold of those thoughts and emotions and buy into the story of inadequacy or low self-esteem? Or do we see the thoughts and emotion, smile at it, know that it's part of the human condition, acknowledge it, let it go, and then continue regardless? So I've said it before, but I'll say it again, coach. You know, we often have no idea what we're capable of. Our potential is limitless. Your potential, runner, is limitless.
That's an awesome insight. It's not just about the goal or how difficult the goal may be to achieve. I love that you start with the reason for the goal. What's the inspiration for the goal? And if the inspiration is not a positive one, that's going to be less fuel for you as you drive towards it. And is the goal really yours if you're primarily doing it to prove someone wrong or hope that you can prove yourself worthy to someone that may not even deserve your time or the effort you give?
100%. And that's why I think it's so important to take some time out to be quiet and to reflect, maybe to get some headspace. You know, we have to be clear about the intention. So the intention is so underrated, and yet it's everything, you know. So setting off without clear intention is, it's like setting sail with no idea of where we're headed, what we're working towards. And sure, we might end up somewhere we like, but we could also end up somewhere we don't like, surrounded by sharks. Or we might just get bored of floating around and head back home again. So intention is everything. But just to be clear, our intention sets our direction, but it's our daily motivation and the focus on one moment at a time that defines our approach and our experience of that journey. And it is a journey. Everything's a journey. Success isn't found in some moment in the future. It's here, in this moment. They're not separate. You can't have that future moment without nailing this moment right now. So do everything you can to create the conditions for a positive outcome. Engage in things that help support your goals and let go of those things that don't. Where possible, surround yourself with those who support you in your goals, even if it's unspoken, and spend less time with those who don't. It's so easy to forget how each and every simple action impacts our broader life.
Exactly. So take the time to think about the sources of inspiration for the goals that you're setting. The more positive and powerful the source, the more positive and powerful the experience will be as you work towards your goals that those sources inspired. So Andy, could you maybe lead our runner into a little alone time here?
Sure thing. So the start point is awareness. Without awareness, there is no way to see clearly that which is helpful and that which is harmful. Without awareness, there's no opportunity to change the way we think, the way we feel, the way we experience the world. So begin by bringing awareness into your run right now. Be present with the body, with the stride. So just to be clear, this isn't about positive thinking, and we're not trying to ignore the difficult aspects of life, and neither are we trying to rigidly maintain or hold on to the things that we like. Life has a flow to it. All we're doing is learning to step back, to see how these things come and go, how they're constantly changing. But if it helps to imagine letting go of baggage from the past, painful memories, challenging storylines, difficult thoughts with each and every step of the run, then now is the time. Leave it all behind. Enjoy that sense of feeling lighter. And likewise, if there's a person or people in your life who inspire you to go further, faster, longer, whatever it might be, then bring them to mind. Allow that inspiration to infuse and power your run. So run with that feeling now for the next few minutes, just letting go of that which has held you down and being powered and infused by that which inspires.
We're getting close to 20 minutes running. That means we're almost halfway done.
We'll be back in a couple of minutes.
We're almost 22 minutes done. Now, if you're doing an out and back, we're done with the out part, and it's time to go back. And I'll tell you what, I'm feeling more positive about my goals truly being my goals. Now, I got more I want to talk to you about, Andy.
Let's do it.
Okay. You work with people every day trying to incorporate a little mindfulness into their lives. And I imagine everyone would love a little more mindfulness every day. How do you tell people to start without being overwhelmed immediately by a task that can suddenly seem too big, too much?
Okay, so just going back to basics. So when we talk about mindfulness, we're talking about being more present in life, less distracted. And when we live like this, we tend to feel a little more calm, more clear, content. We often experience more harmonious relationships too. So rather than having to deal with all the different aspects of software in our life, all the different aspects of life, with mindfulness, we're dealing with the hard drive, the mind, that which influences our entire experience of all those things. But you know this, coach, it's not easy to just suddenly start living mindfully, right? That's where meditation comes in. That's where Headspace comes in. By having a daily meditation practice, even if it's just a couple of minutes a day, where you can learn to be more mindful, so you can then get familiar with that. And we can then begin to integrate it into other activities, like running, for example. So even if you just take a couple of minutes a day, you'll start to see that quality of mind showing up in other areas of your life. It's not that life suddenly changes. It doesn't. It just starts to look a little, or maybe even very, different. Our perspective changes, so our experience changes. But it's important to start small, you know, whether it's training the body or training the mind. Start small and build slowly. So this is a journey for life. And sure, there might be lots of smaller goals along the way, but the attitude is that we're in this for the long haul, that we're doing it because we know it improves our life. And maybe, just maybe, that it positively influences those around us and other people in our communities.
I tell athletes very similar things. Every running goal starts with the statement of the goal. And once you do that, you need to understand that the hard part is not over. That sounds so negative. And I don't mean it that way. I mean it in a really exciting way, actually. A challenge is part of every goal. And stating that you want to achieve a goal is brave and badass. But I need to be honest here. Committing to a race, for instance, isn't hard. What's really hard is committing to the training it takes to run the race. That's hard. That's tough. And that can be scary once you've signed up for the race and you see it there on the calendar, that Saturday circled in red marker. And the reason why that commitment to train is tough is because the commitment demands a recommitment every day. That's the truth. But in that truth, that hard truth, lies the secret to achieving your goal. Since you'll need to recommit every day, you don't need to be constantly thinking about the 20 weeks of marathon training you need to do. And you don't need to be thinking about the long run that you need to do in week 15. You don't need to worry about all the Saturday mornings that you'll run or the speed runs on Tuesdays. Just commit to today. Do that. And don't be overwhelmed by today. Just handle today. That's it. Because if you can keep doing that, it all gets taken care of. And if today gets screwed up, and a whole bunch of today's will, because this is real life and not some PDF training plan. So if today gets screwed up, okay, deal with it and handle that too. Because tomorrow, you need to recommit again. So I just try to remind people that every training day is important, but no training day is the most important. So take it a day at a time, and at the end of the day, look up and make sure you're still heading in the right direction towards that starting line that's circled on your calendar.
Quick question, coach. What if they're not headed in the right direction?
Just figure out why. Mistakes and problems only become a real negative when we don't learn from them. If things are going wrong, take some time to see if what's going wrong actually holds the key to doing things the right way.
Yeah, it reminds me, you know, I think like language, it's tough, right? Like we have to say something, but language can be a real limitation, I feel. Like we have all these phrases like getting it wrong and making mistakes and this kind of thing. And sometimes that's legitimate if we keep doing the same thing and we don't learn from it. But often we are just learning. We have this idea, I don't know where this idea comes from, that somehow we should be able to do all things instantly and with mastery. And that anything different is somehow a reflection of our inability. So we might naturally get impatient, frustrated or stressed when really we're just learning. And I think if we can see this in our running or in our other sort of passions, it can have a profound implication for the rest of our life. So imagine that same frame of mind, that same perspective showing up in other areas of life. Rather than assuming we have all the answers, instead being curious in the process. Rather than assuming there's always someone or something to blame, like understanding that that may not be so. And rather than wanting everything instantly, knowing that the best things in life take time. So that's why we practice meditation. We're not just practicing meditation, we're practicing life. And when we go for a run, we're not just practicing running, we're practicing life. So as you run for the next few minutes on your own, know that this is about so much more than just running. And we'll see you in a few minutes.
Andy, we're over 30 minutes done now. We're in the home stretch.
Seriously, already? It can't be. We just started.
Feels like it. It always feels like that with you, like we just started.
You're too kind.
I'm just speaking the truth.
Well, I'm just happy you feel that way.
You know the deal.
I do.
Okay, I want some more wisdom. You ready?
From me? Well, we can see where it goes.
Okay, let's do it. All right, Andy, I want you to talk to us about those moments. And sometimes they're not moments, they're days or weeks where we question whether we still even want to achieve this goal that we've set for ourselves. Sometimes we break through, we get to the other side, and realize it was just a momentary lull or a brief period where we lacked motivation or inspiration. But other times, we just don't want to go after it anymore. And it may be a legitimate and very real situation where we've changed our priorities. Now, how do we differentiate between giving up on a goal too early and letting go of a goal that we need to leave behind so we can actually move forward?
Yeah, that is, That is such a good question. Tricky question too, you know. I think it can sometimes be tough to get some clarity around what's a legitimate reworking of a goal and what's an excuse, because the original goal feels unattainable or too difficult in some way. And I know I keep going on about this mindfulness thing, but unless we're able to step out of the thinking mind, unless we can be free from confusion, then there can't be any clarity. So however you go about it, be sure to get a few minutes a day, not to think about it, we do that enough already, but to step back from thought and witness more clarity. And when we do this, we're better able to listen to our intuition, or our gut, our heart, our inner voice, whatever you choose to call it. It's a real thing. And the better we know it, the more confident we feel in listening to it. And sometimes we do need to change or readjust our direction and our course, but we should never do it on a whim. So give it a week, maybe even a month, and see how you feel then. Often our changing moods and our emotions can influence a decision. But by giving it time, we can witness the decision through the lens of every day and every emotion rather than just one. And maybe we choose to change the course anyway, and that's okay. But maybe, just maybe, we decide to keep going, understanding that we very nearly bought into a thought that could have derailed our journey. So in short, less knee-jerk decisions and more patient, skillful responses to challenges that happen along the way.
Everything you just said, so, so good. But you know what? We don't have time for me to tell you just how good, because we've only got a little over 6 minutes to go, and we'll be back in just a bit. Okay, we're back. We've got just over 3 minutes to go. and I have one more question for you, Andy.
Ask away.
Okay, it's a personal question for you.
Okay, should I be nervous?
It's too late, because here it goes. What do you do when you've accomplished a goal? What happens? And then what happens next? So tell me about Andy Puttycombe.
It's a good question. I'm not sure if it's all that mindfulness training or what it is, but I don't tend to focus on goals, I think. It may be in the traditional sense of the word, at least not most of the time. I tend to focus more on trying to develop this moment-to-moment awareness, which is, without doubt, a journey for life. And some would even say kind of a goalless goal. You know, I also like the idea of approaching life with curiosity and uncertainty and not really knowing where it's going to take me, but just being confident in the intention, direction and an approach. And I think this is probably like the most important thing, but there are still a few things. In fact, this year, and genuinely, this is probably for the first time in about 20 years or so, I set a few fitness goals. It might even be 30 years. And I'm enjoying it so much. And genuinely, I celebrate going to bed early to get enough rest and recovery. I celebrate waking up early. I celebrate beginning the session, in the middle of the session, ending the session. I celebrate eating something that's going to help me with my next session or recover from the last session. And I celebrate having those people around me who help support and encourage me. So basically, there's a lot of celebration going on. And each and every one is just a tiny, tiny win, but they're part of something bigger. And they're part of working towards a goal. But they're also part of living just a happier and healthier life.
Again, I love it. Thanks for that. Okay, we're close to this run being done. When we do count you down at the end, I'm going to pause the run. And if you want to go further, if you want to run more, well, you can. If you want to add on, you just need to press resume. And if this is all the running you want to do today, well, when we're done talking, just press stop like you do when you end your other runs. Got it? Okay, great. Andy, bring us home.
With pleasure. And wow, by the way, we covered so much today. But I think the key themes, right, are intention, motivation, and presence. Be clear about the goal you're attempting to achieve and knowing why you want to achieve it. This sets our course, our direction. Be clear about what's going to motivate you along the way. What's going to make this goal sustainable? Putting the practical things in place to support your efforts. And then being more present. Letting go of the past. Letting go of the future. Breaking the goal down into one step at a time. Knowing that each step, each moment is inseparable from the goal itself. Knowing that you are inseparable from the goal itself. And you're doing it right now. So be sure to celebrate and appreciate all those things as you cross the line right now in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the run is done.
And another goal achieved. You wanted to start a run? You did. You wanted to end a run? You did. Great job today. And thank you for running towards your goals with Andy and I. It's truly an honor to be invited along for one of your runs. And Andy, thank you for another amazing run. Every time, and I mean this, every single time we do a run together, I end better in so many different ways. And I know the runners with us feel the same way. So thank you.
Hey, the feeling is mutual, Coach. And as always, thanks for having me run with you today. I'm Andy Puttycombe.
And I'm Coach Bennett.
And we'll see you on your next starting line.